Let's talk about jizz, baby. Let's talk about Uncharted 3. Let's talk about jizz, baby. Let's talk about Uncharted 3. Let's talk about jizz, baby. Let's talk about Uncharted 3. Let's talk about jizz, baby. Let's talk about Uncharted 3.
I ain't even know that motherfucking camera's on. Fuck it. Alright, what's going on, you guys? Your favorite nerd, Breezy, you already know what it is. And today, we're going to be getting into my short, quick review of Uncharted 3. I've been playing it all day, finally beat it, just got off work, and I thought I'd give you guys my thoughts. Now, I could sum this review up in basically one word very quick for you, and I'll tell you that word is
jizz.
But see, a guy like me, a nerd like me, you know, Breezy, nobody's like me. I like to, you know, go into detail. So let's go ahead and talk about Uncharted 3. Like I said, I just beat the campaign, and I must say, out of all the games in the Uncharted 3 series, I mean the Uncharted series, I feel this one has the best campaign. Why do I say that? Let me explain. With Uncharted Drake's Fortune, I wasn't into Uncharted like everybody else. You know, maybe people were longtime fans of Uncharted like that. I played Uncharted 1 first. You know, that's why I started. I started actually in Uncharted 2 beta, but then I went back and played Uncharted 1. I love Uncharted Drake's Fortune. Uncharted Drake's Fortune was my favorite Uncharted. Then I got Uncharted 2. Uncharted 2 was a good game. The story was kind of dull for me at first, but then I got into it towards the end because it got more action and everything. But this campaign, crazy. You ever heard of Niggas in Paris? That shit cray. Man, I'm telling you, basically, like, everything, like, I'm talking about the graphics have been upgraded in the story. The cutscenes, like I said, are amazing. The story, I mean, the way I was in Uncharted 2 is, like, I play the game, and then I want to put it down and play it later. When I played Uncharted Drake's Fortune, I played that game when I woke up. I remember how I was. I literally woke up at 3 o'clock in the morning and played that game till about 8 in the morning. I did not want to put that game down. It's the same way I was when Uncharted 3 Drake's Deception. Once I started playing for real, I couldn't put it down. I had to finish it. And I'm telling you, when they said that this game is the PlayStation 3's signature franchise, they are not lying. I love God of War 3 to death, but this game is way over God of War 3. I'm sorry. Uncharted 3 is killing shit. Plain and simple. If you have never played Uncharted, first of all, what the fuck's wrong with you if you have a PlayStation 3? But if you haven't played Uncharted 3 yet and you're skeptical, let me tell you, the story is amazing. I'm not hyping it up. This is not no PS3 fanboy hype game or shit. No. This by far is the best Uncharted out of the whole series. And I feel like, you know, I heard the little rumors or whatever about it's supposed to be on Uncharted 4. Fuck that. Stop, Naughty Dog. Listen to me. You watch this video? Kill it right now. Stop. Kill it all. Just drop it. Don't even add no more. That's perfect. Unless you're gonna wait like 5 years and drop another Uncharted, do that. But don't drop no more Uncharted on PS3. Just don't do it. Now, aside from the campaign, there's really not too much to talk about. The multiplayer, everything's been really added into the multiplayer. The custom matches, I got a new map. It's called the Brass Knuckle map. It's basically a map that comes like right at the end, towards the end of the campaign. It's a real nice map. Shout out to Truth Timbaland, everybody that was in Malik's stream last night. We all played. We got on there and played a multiplayer match. It was real cool. Like I said, the multiplayer seems pretty solid now. You know, it still has its little problems, but overall, I'm enjoying the multiplayer. I can't, you know, really say nothing bad about the multiplayer anymore. It's pretty good. So that's about it. Now, I'm not going to spoil the story or anything, but one complaint I did have about the Uncharted 3 story is towards the end, you know, things start getting crazy. Events start happening, and everything doesn't really mix within with each other, you know, as far as the story. But once you play towards the end, you'll get everything. But to me, I feel like the ending could have been just a little more epic, because, you know, after all this hype, you know, of the villains and everything, you know, I feel like, you know, it could have been a little bit more epic. Now, don't get me wrong, the ending was epic, and this game is definitely like a movie. it is definitely like a movie. I don't know about Batman. Speaking of Batman, I'm sorry, Uncharted 3 is over Batman's story. Like I said, I didn't even give the game a score yet. I give the game a 9. Just put it out there. But yeah, the game is definitely like a movie, and it could have been a little bit more epic at the end. But the game is fine. It's awesome. So if you haven't played Uncharted 3 yet, go cop it. Go cop it. Go play it. Daryl, go play it. Go buy it. Stop saying you ain't gonna buy it. You know you're gonna buy it. Go buy it and play it. As far as everybody else, go rent it or buy it. Whatever you want to do, just play the campaign. I'm not even telling you to play multiplayer. Just play the campaign. You play the campaign, you love the series, tell them Breezy sent you. Hey, I might be getting a job at Naughty Dog. Who knows? Oh yeah, I just want to say one last thing. Uncharted 3 so hard, all these games want to copy. That shit cray. That shit cray. That shit cray.